I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful. Of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. I have lived in the goodness of God. Yeah. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful.
Oh, yes, you have.
And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything, oh Lord. Your
with me for a moment. Father, we thank you for Sister Bertha. Lord, we thank you for a life well lived. I pray in these next few moments, God, that you are with us. Lord, we already feel your presence. God, I pray, Lord, you surround this entire congregation this morning, and Lord, your grace be real. Lord, we're asking for it this moment. Would you come and be with us? In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Amen.
Sister Bertha has been one of my members for 4.5 years now, and what a joy and honor it has been to be her pastor over these last few years. She was a sweetheart. I loved her. I always enjoy going to see her in the afternoon because she made me happy. She laughed. Usually pastors try to put their loving members on last on the list to visit, because if you put your mean ones on the front, you can end your day happy and not be sad. And she always made me happy. I figured y'all'd get that later. I enjoyed visiting with her and talking with her quite a bit. And though Sister Steedley had a lot going on physically, she always kept her joy. And most of you in this room know who I am and know how I am. And it never failed that every time I either visited her at Baptist Village or she was in the hospital, we'd go to see her, I would always ask her when the baby was due. And first time I ever asked her that, she looked at me and she said, "Are you for real?" Like, "Yep, I heard you were pregnant and I'm here to see it." She loved to laugh and she loved her family. She loved to be in the presence of her family. Just recently, as she passed from this life into the next life, Brother Steedley and her four daughters were standing right there with her, holding her hand as she left this world. One of the big things that Sister Steedley loved was her family. This is not part of my sermon, but I bring this to you because Sister Steedley and I had a conversation recently. She was in the hospital. I found out she was there. It was after 7:30. Visiting hours were getting ready to close, and I made a beeline to get up there to see her. She was by herself, and she asked me if I could stay for a few moments to be with her, pray with her. And I knew she was tired, and I was only going in for a few seconds just to pray with her, check on her. She wanted to have a conversation. I guess Sister Steedley knew that this time was coming. Oftentimes, that happens. And she looked at me and she said, "Pastor, I want you to let them know I love them." She did. She began to name names. She named quite a bit of you. She named them, and she talked about you. Some she wanted me to pray for. Others she wanted me to strangle. That was her words, not mine. There were some of them, she said, "I really want you to lay hands on them, because not only do they need God, they need somebody to knock them out." She began to name her kids and grandkids and great-grands. She named it with love, named every one of you with love. She even called some of the extended family's names out, and she said, "Pastor, when you preach my funeral," and at that time we hadn't even discussed that, she said, "I want you to tell my family how much I love them." And I've come this morning to tell you that she loved you with a love that's beyond measure. Her and Brother Steedley had been married 55 years, I believe. How many? All these hundreds of years. And they stayed together. They didn't kill each other. That's a modern day miracle. They probably thought about it. The reality is this: you don't stay together that long if you don't love somebody. Amen. Her love ran deep for each and every one of you. I've been part of this family, but I've known this family for a while. A couple of these guys sitting here been in my cabins at camp, and one of the daughters married a cousin of mine. I've known this family for quite some time. I've worked with them. Some of you come to church with us. What a great, incredible family. And it all starts with Brother Steedley and Sister Steedley and their capacity to love each one of you. I lead these words from Sister Steedley this morning. I love you. I've always loved you. And I will always love you. Don't ever forget that. You are mine. And I love you more than you can ever know. Will you bow your heads with me one more time? Father, I thank you for this moment and your grace. And I praise you, God, for your goodness and your mercy. Lord, the same love that Sister Steedley had in her heart, you gave it to her. And God, I pray over this family in this moment that, God, you would minister to them. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
God sent his son. They called him Jesus. He came to love, heal and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my Savior lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because the call, the assurance.
Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 7 through 10, "And lest I should be exalted above measure by the abundance of revelations, a thorn in the flesh was given to me, messenger of Satan to buffet me, lest I be exalted above measure. Concerning this thing, I pleaded with the Lord three times that it might depart from me. And he said to me, My grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness, and therefore most gladly I will rather boast in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Therefore I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in needs, persecutions, and distresses for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong." James chapter 1, James, a bondservant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad. Greetings, my brethren. Count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. Father, I pray you anoint your servant right now. In these few moments, Lord, that we have together, I pray, Lord, you lay your hand upon me. Lord, I ask, God, for your grace in this moment. Lord, we're asking for your presence to be here in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. I want to give you four things this morning that Sister Steedley preached with her life. I don't have to preach her funeral because she's already preached it. She lived it out. She lived her faith out. But there's four things that I want to give you about Sister Steedley that I believe the Lord has orchestrated this morning. Number one, Sister Steedley loved God and she loved her family. She loved God, she loved people. The Bible teaches us in Matthew chapter 22, verse 38 through 40, that the first and great commandment is to love God with all of your heart. And the second one is to love your neighbor as yourself. And on these two commandments hang all the laws and the prophets. She loved you unconditionally. So does Jesus. She loves you more than you can imagine. So does Jesus. You see, she loved God and she loved people. I'm going to tell you, there are times that Sister Steedley probably scratched her head about some of us. There are probably times, if we're really honest, we were unlovable. There are probably times, going back to what I said earlier, she wanted to strangle you. She probably even told you. There are moments that I'm sure she thought, what are we thinking? I gotta believe that God probably thinks the same thing about us sometimes. Yet that doesn't change the fact that Sister Steedley, even though we probably gave her great challenges at times, she still loved us unconditionally. It doesn't change the fact that even times, Jason, we sometimes mess up. Sometimes we fail God. Sometimes we just make him scratch his head, yet he still loves us right where we are. And he still loves you right where you are. See, Sister Steedley loved you no matter what. Let me say that again. Sister Steedley loved you no matter what. I'm going to tell you, God loves you no matter what. Romans chapter 8 teaches us that nothing can separate us from the love of God. Demons can't do it. Angels can't do it. People can't do it. The devil himself cannot do it. God loves us right where we are. Sister Steedley loved us unconditionally. No matter what any of us done, good or bad, she loved us unconditionally. God does the exact same thing. And she loved earnestly. She loved deeply. 1 Peter 4 and 8 says, "Above all, keep loving one another earnestly, since love covers a multitude of sins." One of the things that I loved about Sister Steedley is that she was genuine. And in her genuineness, you could feel that she genuinely loved you. She genuinely cared for each one of us in this room. And I'm going to tell you today that God does the exact same thing. He loves you genuinely. I'm sure nobody in this room, including myself, is perfect. We all have faults. We all have things that hang us up. Some of us have addictions that we struggle with. Every one of us in this room have all fallen and come short of God's glory. Every single one of us, including myself. But I will tell you, despite all of our issues that we, each one of us, have, there's a God who is calling our name out through his Son, Jesus Christ, who's sitting at the right hand of the Father, calling your name out. That's love, my friends, praying for us. And I'm going to tell you, Sister Steedley prayed hard for each and every single one of you. And she didn't do it just for you to get right. She done it because she loved you. And I'm going to tell you, Jesus loves you just like Sister Steedley loved you. Number two, one of my most favorite things, if probably not my most favorite thing about Sister Steedley, was she had joy. Despite all of her physical limitations, despite the trials and tribulations that she endured through her life, she had joy. And I'm going to tell you something. Joy does not come from money. Joy does not come from being healthy. Joy does not come from having a big house or nice cars or having this or that. Joy comes from a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. You're never going to be happy in this life if you don't have Jesus. Preach, Pastor. I'm going to tell you, you're never going to be happy without Jesus. And you have to choose that relationship with him. You see, because there are bad things that happen to good people. And in this life, the Bible teaches us that we're going to have trials and we're going to have tribulations and we're going to have problems. We're going to have sicknesses. We're going to have infirmities. We're going to have all of these things. And Paul tried to pray it away according to the first scripture that we read. He tried to pray it away and the Lord said, no, in this life you're going to have problems, but my grace is sufficient for you. And Paul got to a point, he said, I'm going to glory in all of this. It's not that I'm going to be excited that I'm going through a battle. It's not going to be exciting that I'm going through a sickness or a trial or a tribulation. But the Bible clearly teaches us to be of good cheer. He's already overcome this world. Nehemiah 8 and 10 is one of my favorite most passages of scriptures. And in that passage of scripture, it says, and do not be grieved, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. I've seen Sister Steedley in great pain at times, and yet she still laughed. How, Pastor? Because there's something about having a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. There's something about knowing him. There's something about having that intimacy with him that despite everything, you can laugh. You can enjoy life. Listen, this moment on earth is simply that, a moment. The Bible describes it as a vapor. We're here and we're gone. And the reality is, it's a short period of time. Why not have the joy of the Lord while you're here? Why not have the joy that Sister Steedley gave such great examples of by living her life, that despite all of her sickness, she had joy. And she had it because Jesus was her Savior. Third thing, she loved, number one. Number two, she had joy. But number three, she knew God would be faithful to her. She knew God would be faithful to her. In the book of Lamentations, chapter 3, the Bible teaches us, and this whole story is the funeral of a city. In the book of Lamentations, as they were preparing for this quote-unquote funeral of the city and the destruction of Jerusalem, Jeremiah wrote these fable words that are so powerful. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercy never comes to an end. They are new every morning, and great is your faithfulness, God, unto us. Can I tell you right now, Sister Steedley was faithful to God, but more importantly, God was faithful to her. You see, God has always been faithful. He knew her before she was even born. He knit her in her womb, and he formed her. He fearfully and wonderfully made her, and he knew how she would be growing up, and he knew how she would be as an adult. He knew the kids that she would have. He knew the grandchildren that she would have and the great-grandkids. He knew who she would marry, and he was faithful to provide everything she needed. And I'm here to tell you this morning, God was faithful to Sister Steedley right up to the very end. I was standing in that room. She left this world. And I'm here to tell you, as her pastor, I don't preach anybody into heaven. That's not my thing. But I will tell you, there was peace that passes all understanding in that room on Saturday as we were standing there. Why? Because Sister Steedley had a relationship with a faithful God who was faithful right up to the end. And her eyes met the faithful one in that moment. The Bible teaches us in 2 Thessalonians chapter 3 that the Lord is faithful and he will establish you and guard you against the evil one. She knew she loved like God. She knew God was faithful. She had great joy. And lastly, this morning, and you're going to have to bear with me for a second. I believe God speaks to people. You believe that? I still believe God speaks. And those of you who go to my church that God has entrusted me with, you know how I am. And so all since this day has I knew this was coming upon me. I've been praying and seeking, and every day the Lord has been telling me one song to get up here and to share with you. And when I walked into this building this morning and the boys handed me to line up for the service, I about fell out, because the very first song is what I'm fixing to preach to you. You see, the fourth thing about Sister Steedley that I loved was that she knew God was good regardless. And in Psalms 23, verse 6, it says, "Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Matter of fact, on my iPad up here, I've got the lyrics printed to "Goodness of God." I want you to hear this morning. It says, "I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I have been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up and until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God." Despite everything that Sister Steedley went through over the last several years, especially with her help, one thing with her health, one thing that she done that I loved, at least that she told me, was that God had been good to her. And I'm going to tell you, for every one of us in here, sinner, saint, in between, don't know what you are, God's good to you. God's been 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 good to you. And I'm going to tell you, and I can tell Brother David this morning, that though the love of his life is now resting in the arms of Jesus, God is still good, Brother David. I can tell you, girls, that no matter what, that even though Mama is gone and she's resting at the feet of Jesus Christ, God is still good to you. I'm going to tell all of you grandkids, great-grandkids, and spouses, and cousins, and everybody that's connected, and Brother Hall, you know it, you've preached it so well so many times, that no matter what's going on in this earth, God is still good to every single one of us. And here this morning lies an example of somebody who has experienced the goodness of God. Goodness and mercy has followed her every step of the way. I will tell you, as her granddaughter Kelly and I have discussed, it's amazing that Sister Steedley lasted as long as she did. I don't mean that ugly. I'm just telling you, there were times I thought, as her pastor, that God was getting ready to take her home. But God's goodness and God's mercy and God's grace came in each time and done the work that was needed. And Brother Steedley, God kept giving you time and kept giving you girls time and kept giving you time. And over again, God kept coming through. Why? He's a good God. He's a good God. So this chorus of this song simply says, in all my life, you have been faithful. All my life, you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I don't know anything about Sister Steedley singing. She never personally sung to me. But that night that I was standing in her room and she and I were having this heart-to-heart, in-depth talk, one of the things that she said to me that has resonated in my spirit ever since, she said, things have not always been easy, but God has always been good. Can I tell you right now, in this life, there are trials and tribulations. There is heartache. There's heartbreak. Live long enough and somebody's going to hurt your feelings. Amen. You have experiences in life that are not always good. Can I tell you this? Love God anyhow. Love your family anyhow. Love God anyhow, despite the things that go on in this world. And love your family unconditionally. I'm coming up on 2 years of my dad suddenly passing. I will tell you that the second year has been the hardest for me. It's not always like that for everybody else, but the second year has been the biggest challenge, I would say. But can I tell you, despite that challenge, God is still good. God is still faithful. And I'm thankful for the time that God gave us. He gave us 80 years with Sister Steedley on this earth. So she loved God. And I'm going to tell you, love God, love your family, despite everything. Can I add one more in there because the Lord just won't let me leave it alone? Forgive. Oh my. Forgive. If Jesus can forgive you of your sins, you can forgive others of theirs. Matthew chapter 6, verse 14. Why is that important? Because if you can't forgive others of their sins, God cannot forgive you of yours. There is nothing worth holding on to and missing out on seeing Jesus Christ. Oh, preach, Pastor. There's nothing worth holding on to. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. A couple of years ago, we have a trampoline and my kids were out there and one of my sons, Aiden, was aggravating my daughter, Heaven. And Heaven's had a lot of medical challenges when she was born, and we're grateful that she's even alive. She's a testimony of God's faithfulness. Heaven come to me crying. She said, Aiden's aggravating the snot out of me. Me being me, I said, well, beat the snot out of him. So she goes back, and Linda and I are turned around and we're talking, sitting on the patio, and I look back to see Aiden in the air. Heaven had picked him up on the trampoline. He's scrawny little bony thing, and then threw him down on the trampoline. Don't call defects. I told Heaven after that, after I got done laughing, I told Heaven after that, don't let him get under your skin. Forgive and move on. Hear me, my friends. Don't let the enemy get under your skin and make you have bitterness. One of the things I loved about Sister Steedley, when she didn't leave this world bitter, she left it in joy. You don't want to meet God not knowing Jesus. You want to meet him knowing Jesus. She loved God. She loved her family. She had joy. She knew that God would be faithful. And I'm going to tell you, God's going to be faithful to you. You're not alone. Not alone. You'll never be alone. The Bible tells us, Brother Steedley, we have angels encamped round about us. We are never alone. Never. And I will tell you in closing this morning, God's good. God is good. God is good. I do it with every one of my members. In the book, Applause of Heaven, Matthew Licato writes that when we get home, there's going to be all these cloud of witnesses that are cheering us as we're beginning to walk up to the throne room to meet God the Father. They're going to be cheering us and applauding us for making it home. And then the one who would rather die than live without us will remove his nail-scarred hands and he will begin to applaud us making it home. Will you stand with me and let's applaud Sister Steedley for making it home to the throne room of the Lord. You may be seated. Father, I bless this family. I bless them. Do your work in them, Lord. Touch and move. Overshadow them. God, I pray that you surround Brother Steedley and the girls and their families. God, I pray you touch. And God, the life and legacy that Sister Steedley lived before them, I pray, God, it will push them to have the same life and legacy. God, I praise you for Sister Steedley. I praise you, God, that I was able to be her pastor. I praise you, God, for the opportunity to minister to her. I praise you for this family. They are precious friends, close friends. God, I pray you hear your servant's cry. God, you will move upon them. You will touch. In Jesus' name, amen.
Every day this never-ending pressure tries to take its claim over my heart. I have tried to hold it all together, but time and time again I fall apart. But that's where I find my life was never mine at all. But you are the one inside, always in control. So when it feels like all of this pain is never gonna end, brought to my knees by all of these things I don't understand, don't understand. Letting go of worries I can't measure, holding on to truth that's healing me, knowing I can trust you is a treasure. sight, always in control. So when it feels like all of this pain is never gonna end, bow to my knees by all of these things I don't understand, don't understand. I will let the weight of my fear fall like sand out of my hands and into yours, out of my hands and into yours. Take this out of my hands, take this out of my hands, take this out of my hands, it's out of my hands. There's nothing that you can't handle, God, you are strong enough. Only you can take this out of my hands, out of my hands. You're greater than all my sorrows, worthy of all my trust. Thank you, Lord, that this is out of my hands, out of my hands. So when it feels like all of this pain is never gonna end, fall to my knees by all of these things I don't understand, I don't understand. Out of my hands. It's out of my hands.